passed.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Colleagues, Senate Bill 817B eliminates fees, fines, and court costs associated with juvenile delinquency matters, both retroactively and proactively. It provides for court-appointed counsel at state expense for all juvenile delinquency matters. The measure expands no-cost access to transcripts and recordings of proceedings. It states that if a young person is committed to the Oregon State Hospital, the person's ability to pay and cost of care will be determined under the ability to pay rules, and that services and treatments may be paid for by the youth and family through private insurance or other private means. Finally, it makes related judgments entered prior to January 1, 2022 for fines, fees, costs, and other monetary obligations null and void and considered satisfied. It does not impact restitution to victims of crimes, only the fines and fees used to recover administrative costs and monetary sanctions. Jurisdictions consistently generate little to no net revenue from juvenile fines, fees and fines, which are collected at low rates with high costs. To approach this purely from a math angle, it's bad math. Nearly 90% of juvenile court debt is more than 5 years old, which the Oregon Judicial Department considers virtually uncollectible. In 2019, we spent $866,000 to collect $864,000 in fees. From the humanity angle, 96% of parents who owe OYA fees earn less than $2,000 a month. These fines and fees represent a barrier to success, weighs on the families that already struggle with making ends meet, and there are studies linking juvenile fees and fines with increased recidivism. To many of these families, these fees and fines are a financial burden. They cannot bear this while struggling to put food on the table, make rent, and keep the lights on and the water running. A broad coalition of stakeholders representing youth offenders and state judicial and justice departments all support this bill. Bipartisan advocacy groups support this bill. Senator Manning and I have worked together with advocates and champions for change on juvenile fines and fees and are proud to see this pass today. This is a common sense bill that will help every impacted party and most of all give a sigh of relief to families in need across Oregon. Colleagues, I urge an aye vote. Thank you.